So I think people with depression have the reputation for feeling sorry for themselves or that they fell into a bad mood and were too lazy to get themselves out of it. But believe me when I tell you, I'm not lazy, nor did I approach this lazily. Like, I went to a psychiatrist and a psychologist, and if you don't know the difference, congrats, you're having a great life. I became a vegan to feel better. I quit smoking to feel better. Pretty much every exercise plan there is, I try to feel better. Meditation. I went on a 7-day silent meditation retreat. Medication. I've tried every medication they have, and they all have side effects, whether it's weight gain, weight loss, nausea, grogginess, memory loss, which for my job is not good, and worst of all, dick stuff. So I'd been on antidepressants for 17 years, and finally I was like, I have to do something. I have to try something else. So I was so sick of the side effects that I was like, I need to throw a Hail Mary. So heard of this drug, ketamine? Yeah, if you know what ketamine is, it's a horse tranquilizer that's also a party drug, and they've started prescribing it for depression. I know it's legit because I saw it on Reddit. So I found a doctor that prescribes it, and I went to his office, and I can't explain to you how normal this doctor's office was. Like, a bunch of other people waiting for other doctors, fill out the form, old magazines. They call me back into his office, put an IV in my arm, drip ketamine into it, and I trip my fucking face off. On a Tuesday afternoon in a doctor's office, immobile, out, music festival level, not on this plane, gone. And it lasted about 45 minutes, but the come down was rough. Like, when I came out of it, I felt like I just came out of surgery, which makes sense because it is an anesthetic. So I decided not to do it again, and then woke up the next day and felt better than I'd felt in months, and I was like, fuck, I gotta do it again. Did it 5 more times in the next 2 weeks. But long term, the side effects from ketamine were bad for me. It was like, I got nauseous for months, I was groggy for months, and worse than that, my eyes burnt for 4 months straight. It was crazy. So that didn't work for me. Then I heard about something called TMS. TMS is short for transcranial magnetic stimulation. All right, so this is another, looked it up online, go to a doctor's office, and they put a contraption on your head, looks like kind of a halo, and they basically shoot magnetic beams into your brain, about an inch deep into your brain, to a certain area that stimulates growth and can alleviate depression, allegedly. So I did that. That lasts about a half an hour of just, it just feels like tapping. It just feels like a kind of a shitty woodpecker. You're like, okay, let's wrap it up now. And by the second treatment of that, I felt great, like something definitely lifted. The depression's still with me, but it's not nearly as bad as it was. I ended up doing a total of 45 half-hour sessions of TMS, which is a lot. And the reason I itemize it is because when you have any kind of mood disorder, it's not provable to people. All I have to show you is my work. Like, I had 45 half-hour sessions. It's really aggravating when you have a mood thing because you can feel people's suspicion. Imagine if you had a cold and people were like, he doesn't really have that cold. That stuffiness is a choice. Yeah, it's really frustrating, and it speaks to people's ignorance about depression.